I'm Dr. Chris Shepherd, chiropractor, co-founder of the Runners Academy. And today I have with me Lindsay Scott, one of our physiotherapists here. And we're going to talk about running technique. So we get asked questions a lot. What is the number one question we get asked?
So by far people are most interested in what is the one thing that I could do to improve my overall run technique. So both with the perspective of I want to make sure that I stay healthy and not injured, as well as I want to be as efficient and fast as I can be. So the main error I would say that we see is people who land too far in front of themselves relative to where their body is. So we call this overstriding. And the problem with this is that means that with every step you take, you're creating a braking or a slowdown moment that you then have to overcome again, as well as it just opens you up to a lot more opportunity for injury to happen.
So ultimately what we want to see then is that you're landing in a position that looks like this. And we call this a shin vertical position because your shin is in a vertical position relative to the ground. And this is just a better position to shock absorb and then push off. So we want to get rid of the braking or minimize the braking as much as we can. So today what we're going to do is we're going to have Lindsay jump on the treadmill and show you in real time what that looks like. So somebody overstriding, and then what we want to see with the technique that we use to minimize overstriding.
And then we'll take you through really quickly one drill that can help you try and integrate that into your own running.
So the drill that we like to use is called the step over drill. We're going to demonstrate this here for you. So Lindsay, what I want you to think about is that you have a peg or something sticking out just of your ankle, and you have to step over it. So step over, okay, and keep going here. So just step over, and you think about stepping over and pushing the ground away. Good. And now come on back and put this into a little bit of a run form. So spring to it, step over, step over. Okay. And so how do we incorporate this into your running now?
So once you've done that a couple of times as part of your warm-up to get used to that movement pattern, and then we're going to get you to, for around 30 seconds to a minute at the beginning of every kilometer, you're going to really focus on that cue, then just finish your kilometer running, and once you hit the next kilometer, refocus on it again.
Yep. And the idea here is that you want to slowly make the change. So you can feel the difference between the old way and the new way. And eventually, your brain will choose the less braking.
Yep, perfect. There we are. Happy running.